Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we're going to have a Friday FOTD, and I'm going to feature the MAC Warm Neutrals 15 Shadow Palette, which is this baby right here. I got it very recently during the Cyber Monday sale, and I'll talk to you a little bit more about the palette as we go along. I'm going to show you how I created this eye look using that palette. And first of all, I want to apologize for the lighting because I'm actually at my mom's house here in the Philippines and I don't have my usual sunlight hitting me with a big window simply because it's actually raining here. There's two typhoons in the country at the moment. So if it's a little dark or a little grainy, I apologize for that. And I am hoping that it's going to turn out well. So if you want to see how I created this look and what I think about that palette, then please keep on watching. So as you can see, I've already got the rest of my face on. It's just the eyeshadows that I haven't done. So that's what we're going to do today. And I'm going to start with a base color, this one here. It's called Saddle and it's a matte color. And I'm going to put that all over my eyes. I'm going to do one eye first and then off camera, I'm going to do the other eyes in the effort to save some time. I'm just using my mirror from my e.l.f. palette. So I'm going to do that and I'm going to apply that with a fluffy brush all over the lids. And this is going to be the base that's going to help create the transition as well as help as well as help to make the eyeshadows blend better. So there you go. Okay, now I'm going to go in with Dance in the Dark, which is another matte right here, and I'm going to take that with a smaller fluffy brush. I'm going to take that the outer corner, sweep it towards the inside like so, and then bring that onto the crease. I've turned the blending brush onto its side so that it's easier to deposit that color, and I'm just sweeping it inwards. That's okay if it's not perfect. We're gonna fix that in a little bit. I'm gonna go back with that brush that we used for the first time. I'm gonna use that to blend that crease color that we have just applied so that it's not too stark. There you go. See that? Now I'm gonna go in with a flat shader brush. I'm gonna go in with this beautiful sort of pinkish color here called Ginger Snap. And I'm going to lay that all over the lid. And that's going to be your pop of color. This is I never thought I was going to be attracted to the color pink, but this is just gorgeous. And I'm putting that all over the lid up to the crease and then going to do a windshield wiper motion to blend that in. The other side of the brush, I'm going to flip that over and I'm going to go in with Lemon Tart, which is another satin shade that's more of a yellow gold, a light yellow gold. I'm going to apply that at the inner corner, working its way up to meet with the pink so that it's got that nice highlight. You see that? Again, I'm going to go in with this brush, which we used earlier to lay down Saddle. And I'm gonna use that to blend. I'm gonna go in with Brulee, which is this matte, it's a satin shade. I'm gonna go in there with that same brush that we used earlier. And that's going to be our brow bone highlight. That's going to help as well to blend the rest of that eyeshadow. Okay. I'm going to take that dark color that we used earlier and I'm going to try and deepen that outer corner and also to blend it out with that same brush. I didn't add any product onto the brush. I am just really using what is left on it. There you go. And then I'm going to try and put a little bit of that under the eye, just all the way to the center, not all over the waterline. That way, it blends the rest of the eyeshadows in. Now what's going to happen is, I'm going to put a thin layer of eyeliner because I'm going to put some false lashes on, and I don't want the false lashes to look really false. You know what I mean? So I'm just really going to follow my lash line. That's going to be the base. Just really follow that. No extra wings or anything like that. And then towards the outer half, I am going to double the width of that liner so that it looks like it's thicker on the outside and thinner on the inside. There you go. You see that? Once that's done, I'm going to put on mascara, and I'm going to be using my Maybelline Lash Sensational, and I'm also going to put on false lashes, and I'm going to be using my Ardell Demi Wispies. I'm not going to show that on camera anymore in the effort of saving some time. So let's get on with it. So that's the finished look for you guys. Now let's talk about the actual palette. This is $85 on the MAC website, but I got it when they had a Cyber Monday sale and they had 25% off on all of their holiday kits. I'm not sure if that sale is still going on by the time that this goes up. Probably not, because I don't have any means to edit this right now, so it's probably going to have to wait until January. Anyway, this palette has got 15 shades in it. I'm going to tell you what are those shades. Okay, we'll start from here. You've got Hay, which is a Velux Pearl. I'm going to try and see. Okay, this is Hay, Velux Pearl. That's Warm Breeze, which is a Satin. Ginger Snap is a Frost. Dark Brew is a Velvet. Dance in the Dark is a Matte. You've got Brulee, which is a Satin. Vanilla Extract, which is a Frost. Honey Lust, which is a Luster. Amber Lights is a Frost. Saddle is a Matte. Lemon Tart is a Velux Pearl. Creative Copper is a Luster. Butter Fudge is a Satin. Divine Decadence is a Velvet. And Unwind is a Velux Pearl. So those are the shades that are included. And I am just checking if my, yeah, okay. Those are the shades that I included, that are included. I used four of them on this look today, and they are all really nice and pigmented. And I am kicking myself for not buying them sooner, but I'm also happy that I waited because I got them for 25% off during the Cyber Monday sale. So $85 turned out to be $63.75, and for 15 shadows that are MAC, that's a pretty good deal, really. The value of this palette is actually $160, because each pan is about $10 when you buy them individually, and the palette itself is also $10. So 15 times 10 is 150, plus the $10 palette is 160. To get it for $85, which is almost half the price, is a very, very good deal. So if you can get your hands on them, go ahead and do that. I'm going to also be inserting the swatches of the shades somewhere, okay, when I do the editing for this, but they're all very pigmented, and when I swatched this, there was no base. It's all one swipe, so it's pretty good, and I do love it, and I am very, very thankful that I got this, because I do love my warm neutrals. I used to be like a color freak, but now that I've matured a little bit, I now prefer to do a little bit more neutral. It's more wearable, and I find that I have a lot of colors that I don't really end up using anyway, so going for a neutral is a very, very good option, and it gives you a lot more use and a lot more bang for your buck. All right. So yep, that's what I think about it. I also have a blog post about this on OneProudPinay.com. I'm going to try and link that down below if I don't forget. But yeah, I I like how it turned out. I like how the look turned out. It's very simple and understated. Yeah. So thank you very much for watching. Subscribe if you haven't already. If you have any comments or questions, please do write them down below and I'd be more than happy to answer. And give me a like if you like this video. Bye.